Have you ever wondered if aloe vera really works as a natural rooting hormone, or if it's just another gardening myth? Welcome to the channel. Aloe vera isn't just for skin, hair, and health. It's also widely talked about in gardening, especially as a natural rooting hormone. It contains auxin-like compounds that signal plant cells at a cut site to de-differentiate and then reform as root cells. The problem is that its auxin levels are very small, often not enough for hard-to-root plants, though sometimes sufficient to give easy-to-root plants a little boost. 4 years ago, I carried out an experiment to test aloe vera's effectiveness as a rooting hormone for propagating ZZ plant leaves. The experiment involved three separate groups, each using a different medium: pure water, water mixed with aloe vera gel, and pure aloe vera gel. The results were quite clear, and ultimately, they did not favor aloe vera as a rooting hormone. The leaves placed in pure water had the best results by far. All of them successfully grew roots, demonstrating that for ZZ plants, water alone is an effective medium for propagation. In contrast, the group using water mixed with aloe vera gel had a lower success rate, with two of the leaves rotting before they could establish roots. The worst outcome came from the leaves placed directly in pure aloe vera gel. All of them rotted completely. The reason for this is likely oxygen deprivation. Aloe vera gel is thick and viscous, creating a sealed environment around the cut end of the leaf. This cuts off oxygen, creating anaerobic conditions that starve the cells of the air they need for survival and root formation. It also encourages anaerobic bacteria and fungi, which rapidly leads to rot. My second experiment using aloe vera as a rooting hormone focused on propagating dwarf rose cuttings. I took 6 cuttings from a single small rose plant and divided them into 3 experimental groups. The first group served as the control, with cuttings planted directly into soil. The second group's cuttings were dipped in aloe vera gel before being planted. For the third group, I inserted the cuttings into small pieces of aloe vera leaves before planting them in soil. The final results varied, and again, they didn't provide a strong case for aloe vera. The control group had one successful cutting that developed roots, while the other failed. Interestingly, the second group, which used the gel dip method, also had only one successful cutting, but its roots were visibly longer than those of the successful control cutting. The third group, which used the full aloe vera leaf method, was a complete failure, as none of the cuttings grew roots. It's worth noting that since all the cuttings came from the same plant, differences in size or maturity may have influenced the outcome. For my third experiment, I chose a resilient plant, grapevines. This time I worked with nodes, the swollen sections of the vine where new growth emerges. These bumps are where most of the action happens, new leaves, buds, and eventually new roots, though roots can also grow in the internodes. I carefully selected 8 healthy nodes, each with a visible growth bump. I divided them into 2 groups of 4. The first group was planted directly into soil as a control. For the second group, I cut fresh pieces of aloe vera leaf and embedded the grapevine nodes into the gel before planting. With grapevine nodes, you never bury them completely. The bump must stay exposed above the soil, so I made sure to do this for both groups. Unfortunately, this experiment faced an unexpected setback. I got busy and completely forgot about the nodes. The soil dried out for a very long time, and I thought they had all died. Although they survived, their condition was severely compromised. I knew the lack of consistent moisture had likely affected their growth, but I still wanted to see the outcome. Despite the neglect, the results were fascinating. The first group, planted in pure soil, did remarkably well. All 4 grew. One is still recovering from the dryness, but has lots of healthy roots, so I know it will bounce back. Another one almost died. But it had already started growing roots again, showing just how tough grapevines are, so I replanted it. The other 2 are thriving and a testament to how little these plants need to get started. The aloe vera group also grew, with 3 surviving and 1 dying after the dry spell. What was interesting was that even the dried out one began to grow roots again after watering, so I replanted it. I had expected aloe vera to give the nodes a boost, but in the end, there was no significant difference between the aloe vera group and the control group. Looking at these 3 experiments together, ZZ plants, roses, and grapevines, a clear pattern emerges. While aloe vera does contain compounds that can encourage rooting, the concentration seems too low to make a consistent difference in many plants. On the other hand, too much aloe vera gel can actually harm propagation by cutting off oxygen and promoting rot. I'll continue testing aloe vera with different plants to see if there are any cases where it truly shines as a rooting aid. I hope you learned something from this video. This is Danny. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. God bless you.